the holy month of September. Tell me. Oh. The holiest of holies. Earth, wind, and fire. Do you remember? 21st night of September. Woo! Tell me. So, I do. Amazing time, I tell you. Woo! Ah. How you guys doing? How you guys doing? What a difference a day makes, huh? I recorded the video yesterday. I was frustrated. Today I'm less frustrated. I really am happy. And hopefully the best is yet to come and things will change. And with all the respect and love for Robinhood investors, hopefully they will get off our backs. All right, this is the Dow Industrial, the daily time frame, and this is the Elliott Wave Count. Amazingly, still holds where we have five waves down. We had wave one, and we have complex correction. We have an ABC up, W, and X, another ABC. We concluded wave two with the Y. I think this is it. I really do. I really, really do. But I might be wrong, but at least I have this roadmap. I always have to believe. I must believe. I must believe. I'm not going to be a Robinhood investor. I've been in the market for decades. I'm better than that. We are better than that. All of you are better than that. All right. So this is the conventional technical analysis. We have one black crawl in the Japanese candles right here. And we closed well below this low, and we had buyers at the 20-day moving average, which is the algos will buy it all the time, especially if it's sloping up. So that was an easy buy. So we closed outside the Bollinger Band, then we had the resistance, then boom, we went down. So this is it, and the volume is, wow. Definitely, I classify this bad boy as a distribution volume. And this is not updated. I think it's going to go right up, way up, way up, way up. Let me see if I can update this bad boy. Mm-hmm. It's almost, oh God. All right, it's extremely close to these people, to these volumes. Okay, this is definitely a distribution volume, no doubt about that. I think it's coming. I really do. I really, really do. And as I said yesterday about the bearish divergence from this time length to this time, which was June to September, and the RSI, and the shorter time from August to September. And I said many, many, many times, even if some chartists don't believe in negative divergence, they believe only the chart. I told you guys yesterday, I beg to differ. I really, some people out there, they say false information. Thank God I did not rely on them. Thank God I relied on the books in the old days. I did not hear people on YouTube at that time. I didn't have YouTubes when I started to. Studying the market, almost no net. I was in the 90s, and thank God, they really would distract me. Negative divergence and positive ones, they really, really work. They really, really work. And also, this one, we have a negative divergence right here. See, this is the second worst pullback since the bottom right here. It was negative divergence. It went down from almost 25,000 to 22,000 something. So this is almost 15%. And same thing happened here in the IWM. This is the Dow. And boom, we have this. And now we have in this. This is the worst day since this day right here. And they all, three of them, all came with negative divergence. So negative divergence really, really did work. So this is the conventional technical analysis. Let's look at the VIX. All right. Wow, big price expansion to the upside. And what differs this one right here from this expansion right here? The Bollinger Band was not tightened at the time. It was not doing a pipeline formation. This one is doing pipeline formation. Pipeline formation happens before a major trend change. It happened here. And see what happened. Here we did not have a pipeline formation. It's almost like playing the Bollinger Band. You buy at the lower end, you sell outside of the upper end. Then boom, you do the same thing. And it was trending down. And the MACD is in bullish crossover and is above the zero line for the first time since this time. So if we stay above the zero line for 3 days, this is business. This is real. This is really real. And the histogram is not as high. It's not bad. Here was much better, but didn't stay above the zero line, the MACD. So this is for the VIX. And also it has five waves down, and we're doing 1-2, and we're going for 3, according to Elliott Wave, for the VIX. This is the UUP, the ETF for the dollar, and as said many times, 1-2, and we're ready for 3. What's bullish about today? We are forming the pipeline formation, and we are high basing, and we found sellers at the 10 and 20 day moving average, which is okay. A lot of people do that, and people are confused now. What is now the safe haven bet? Is it the bond market or is it the dollar? So the dollar is not blinking right now, and the 10 day and 20 day moving average are flattening now, ready for a volatility. This happens here and it went down. It happened here and it went down. Now I think, according to Elliott, it's gonna go up. So I'm very bullish on the dollar, as you may know already. This is the TLT, the bond ETF. And if you don't believe in bearish divergence and the bullish ones, I tweeted there is a bullish divergence, and it was really breaking down. Right here, this was the low and we broke down, but there's bullish divergence. So I tweeted, I was afraid somebody's shorting it because they trust me, and even though I don't give advices, but some people just follow my opinion. So I tweeted, I was hoping that person would read my tweet. So I said bullish divergence, if he shorts, cover your shorts. And this is what happens, and boom, it really went up violently. So that divergences, I promise you with all my heart, they work, not all the time, but most of the times they mean something. Don't believe the chartists. I really don't know why they do that, but they do it. So today's action, it's like a shooting star, because it came with an up leg shooting star, and they sold at the 62 Feb retracement and an older price memory for the TLT, and also they managed to close below the 50-day moving average, which is not bullish. So my opinion now, and I think by tomorrow, the stochastic is going to be almost close to 80, because it's going to count the next day. And I think down we go. So the bullish divergence did its job, gave us this leg, and now down we go. And I think the dollar would be bullish. Yet, I think there's nothing wrong with the dipper buyers buying the dip now because of the 20-day moving average sloping up. So it is okay for them to buy the market and close above this place. I have to run a Fibonacci retracements from here to here and see where the sellers gather. The price range is very tight, so it's not. I'm not expecting a price expansion to the upside really, really badly. So, in conclusion, I think the B wave the second wave, corrective wave, is concluded, and the negative divergences always work. So this marks the second wave. Triple negative divergence from June to September, from August, September, from September to September. Okay, so you have also a negative divergence here, the smaller ones. from here to here, see? So you have to triple. One, two, and three small ones. So this will be suitable for the second wave. And like what we have here, we had a lot of positive divergences when we concluded the five waves down, which equal to one at that time. So believe you me, if you see a negative divergence, especially in the daily time frame, make sure you cover your shorts. If you shorten, make sure you do something, but don't have a short, because you negative divergence is for a person that has already opened a position, whether it's a long or a short. Just watch out, but don't open a new position based on the negative or positive divergence. Only the price action gives us the signal for opening a position. So I want to make myself clear. So my expectation now, the safe haven is going to be the dollar. The market concluded this down leg, I think, that this is the correction, and I think down we go, and I think we might have volatility on the way and the way down. And you know, it really is weird how what a difference a day makes. Yesterday I was not. Oh, what a difference a day makes, I tell you. What a difference a day makes, guys. I love you guys. Please subscribe if you just watching the channel. Please like if you like. Dislike if you dislike. Please don't be passive. Please don't be passive. Please like, subscribe, and love, and be loved. And remember, life is beautiful. It's gonna get better. And this goes forever!